Hi, I'm Howard Lothrop, host of Echo Partners TV, and I want to speak with you about a topic that is of interest to all of us at least every year or two or three, and that is how should we select an asset liability model? You know, what are the things that you want to know before you select a model? And I'm going to go from big picture to more refined as we look at this. And so let's start with the big picture question first. Number one, are you a large bank? If you're a large bank, you know, over $1 billion in assets, you know, you probably want to get a pretty sophisticated model. And you know, sophisticated models are not my thing. I've been modeling for 30 plus years. And, you know, I've seen a lot of sophisticated models that, you know, not in the proper hands and give some unexpected results. I make no claims to be a sophisticated asset liability modeler. If you're a big bank, you just, you know, go ahead and start looking at the big complex models. The second question you need to ask yourself is, is your balance sheet complex? And by complex, what I mean is, do your assets and liabilities behave normally with respect to interest rate changes? You know, we're talking big picture numbers here. You know, if rates fall, do your prepayments speed up? If rates rise, do your asset durations start to lengthen? Those sorts of things. If you have that sort of relationship with your assets and liabilities, you know, the normal relationship, fine. If you don't, however, if you have inverse floaters or other non-normal, differently reacting types of asset liabilities, if you're loaded up with lots of, optionality. And I don't mean you've got some bonds that are callable or you hold some mortgage backs. I mean if you've got lots of actual raw options, particularly options that react in a non-normal sense, again, you should look at a more sophisticated model. Now for the 7,000 banks that I haven't described so far, those that are less than a billion and don't have an especially complex set of cash flows in their balance sheets, I'm going to suggest that you really need to do two things when you look for an asset liability model. Number one, you need to use the old 80-20 rule. Don't worry about getting the 99.9th percentile of accuracy. What you're going to get by doing that is you're going to spend a lot of money, you're going to spend a lot of time and effort, staff resources, and you're going to get a model that's going to be, difficult to work. It's going to take a lot of time. You're not going to use it. It's going to be hard to get accurate information out of it. And so you're going to stop relying upon it. It's you have an inaccurately precise result that does not help your management at the bank. The other thing that I think you need to do, no matter where you look for an asset liability model, is you want to make sure that that model vendor provides you with a timely and up-to-date third-party independent model validation opinion. And what this does is this is where an independent third party, usually it's a CPA or a consulting firm or another asset liability provider, examines the model for its mathematical certainty and its accuracy, looks at all the algorithms, looks at the underlying theoretical underpinnings of the model, and basically attests to you that it works the way it's supposed to work. The best time to get that from your vendor is before you commit to a purchase. And you should also get a commitment from your vendor to provide an updated a validation opinion annually. It's not really required unless there's some significant change to the model, but with the pace of regulatory change that we've seen recently, I think you'd be safe to say that significant changes occur pretty much annually these days. So there you have it. Number one, if you're not large, if you're not complex, look at a model that's going to give you a bigger bang for your buck, and make sure that you instead of just relying upon somebody else's usage or the market test or any of these other things, get something in black and white where the accuracy and performance of the model has been attested by an independent third party. If you have any questions, just let us know or fill out the comments below, and we'll see if we can address them on a future episode. Thanks very much. See you soon.